The last step on the IQELISA is ensuring a proper plate seal. To seal the plate, place the plate film on top of the plate and grab a flat edge. We like to use a thin, lightweight ruler. The ruler should be used to press the film firmly against the edges of the wells. During the reaction, the thermocycler will reach up to 95 Celsius. Expansion of air will place pressure on the seal. If improperly sealed, that force will lift up the plate film, making it so that evaporation can occur and compromise your fluorescence readings. Each reaction should be maintained in a closed system contained within each well. If there are too many air pockets within the seal, this will also cause issues, especially if it's around the sides. The more pockets and unsealed areas on the sides, the less pressure required to lift up the seal and the easier it is to compromise the closed system. To avoid an evaporation edge effect, be sure to flatten out the surface and then seal around the edges. Our technicians first press down between the wells in a grid-like fashion and then seal off the sides. This method ensures that each well is a closed system and that there is no edge effect. Now you are ready to run the IQELISA through your thermocycler under specified cycling conditions. Following the experiment, check the melt cover for indication of contamination, the wells for potential evaporation, and the seal for any potential issues. If any are noted, you can document them in your output to see if there are errors in plate sealing cause an experimental outlier. If you have any questions about your data or how to analyze it, send it over to technical support at techsupport@raybiotech.com, and our support team will be happy to assist you. Or if you would like our certified service team to run your next IQELISA experiment, just fill out a quote request form on our website and we'll be happy to assist you. It's the price of the kit plus $5 per plate to run it.